and brothers and sisters, please stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
In the name of the Father, the Son, of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God, And to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who called the Bishop Saint Irenaeus to confirm true doctrine in the peace of the Church, grant, we pray, through his intercession, that being renewed in faith and charity, we may always be intent on fostering unity and concord through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the second book of Kings. In the 10th month of the 9th year of Zedekiah's reign, on the 10th day of the month, Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, and his whole army advanced against Jerusalem, encamped around it, and built a siege walls on every side. The siege of the city continued until the 11th year of Zedekiah. On the 9th day of the 4th month, when famine had gripped the city and the people had no more bread, the city walls were breached. Then the king and all the soldiers left the city by night through the gate between the two walls that was near the king's garden. Since the Chaldeans had the city surrounded, they went into the direction of the Arabah. But a Chaldean army pursued the king and overtook him in the desert near Jericho, abandoned by his whole army. The king was therefore arrested and brought to Riblah, to the king of Babylon, who pronounced sentence on him. He had Zedekiah's son slain before his eyes. Then he blinded Zedekiah, bound him with fetters, and had him brought to Babylon. On the seventh day of the fifth month, this was in the 19th year of Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, Nehuzaradan, captain of the bodyguard, came to Jerusalem as the representative of the king of Babylon. He burned the house of the Lord, the palace of the king, and all the houses of Jerusalem. Every large building was destroyed by fire. Then the Chaldean troops who were with the captain of the guard tore down the walls that surrounded Jerusalem. Then Nebuzaradan, captain of the guard, led into exile the last of the people remaining in the city, and those who had deserted to the king of Babylon, and the last of the artisans. But some of the country's poor, Nebuzaradan, captain of the guard, left behind as vine dressers and farmers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you.
Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you.
By the streams of Babylon, we sat and wept when we remembered Zion. On the aspens of that land, we hung up our harps.
Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you.
Though there our captors ask of us the lyrics of our songs, and our despoilers urge us to be joyous, sing for us the songs of Zion.
Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you.
How could we sing a song of the Lord in a foreign land? If I forget you, Jerusalem, may my right hand be forgotten.
Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you.
May my tongue cleave to my palate if I remember you not, if I place not Jerusalem ahead of my joy.
Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus came down from the mountain, great crowds followed him. And then a leper approached, did him homage, and said, "Lord, if you wish, you can make me clean." He stretched out his hand, touched him, and said, "I will do it. Be made clean." His leprosy was cleansed immediately. Then Jesus said to him, "See that you tell no one, but go show yourself to the priest and offer the gift that Moses prescribed. That will be proof for them." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Magandang tanghali po sa kanilang lahat. Kami po ay mga pilgrims. We came all the way from the parish of Our Lady of the Most Holy Rosary. Mula po kami sa parokya ng Mahal na Birhen Santo Rosario sa Malipangpang, San Ildefonso, Bulacan. Ito po ay bahagi ng aming paghahanda para sa aming sentenaryo, ika-100 taong pagdating ng aming patron, ang Mahal na Birhen ng Santo Rosario o kilala namin bilang si Apo Sayong. At napakaganda ng ating pagdiriwang sa araw na ito dahil naalala natin ang isang nagpakita, ang isang magandang halimbawa, si San Irenaeus, Bishop and Martyr. Pag sinabi nating martyr, pinakita niya yung kanyang pananampalataya sa pamamagitan ng pag-aalay ng kanyang buhay. By the shed of his blood, pinakita niya yung kanyang pananampalataya. Hindi lamang si St. Irenaeus ang nagpakita ng kanyang pananampalataya. Even the prophets in the Old Testament, at even sa New Testament, maraming mga nagpakita ng kanilang pananampalataya na kahit na ibigay yung kanilang buhay, ay gagawin nila. Ano nga ba ang common sa mga tinawag para ibigay ang kanilang pananampalataya kay Irenaeus? Ano ba makikita nating common sa kanila? Meron tayong makikitang tatlong bagay sa mga nag-alay ng kanilang sarili tulad ni Irenaeus. Una, these people are called. Sila ay tinawag. Hindi batay sa kanilang kulay, hindi batay sa kanilang pinanggalingan, kundi batay sa kanilang kahandaan para sumunod sa kalooban ng Diyos. Si Irenaeus ay tinawag. Dala yung kanyang pananampalataya sa Diyos. At ang kanyang inihandog sa simbahan ay walang iba kundi yung kanyang pananampalataya na ating tinatamasa ngayon. Tinitignan ng simbahan ang halimbawa ni Irenaeus sa kanyang karunungan, sa kanyang pag-aalay ng buhay. Pinapaalala sa atin, siya ay tinawag ng Diyos. Pangalawa, ano makikita natin sa mga tao katulad ni Irenaeus? Hindi lamang po sila tinawag, binigyan sila ng mission. God entrusted special mission for them. At ano ang kanila ng magiging mission? Walang iba kundi ipakilala ang Diyos, ipakilala si Jesus, ipakilala ang kagandahang loob ng Diyos, ipakilala ang kabutihang loob ng Diyos, ipakilala na ang Diyos ay buhay. Ano ang kanilang misyon? Ang kanilang misyon ay buhayin ang pag-asa ng bawat mananampalataya, lalo na yung mga tao na dumadaan sa matinding problema, yung mga tao na dumadaan sa dilim, yung mga tao na naghahanap ng liwanag sa kanilang buhay. And these people, like Irenaeus, sila ay tinawag, binigyan ng misyon, Para nang sa ganon, tayo na naghahanap ng liwanag, ng pag-asa, kapag nakita natin ang mga taong ito, maalala natin na ang Diyos ay buhay. Pangatlo, ano ba ang makikita natin sa mga taong katulad nila Ireneus? Walang iba kundi ito. Ang lahat ng tinawag, ang lahat ng binigyan ng misyon ay patuloy na pinalalakas ng Diyos. Kaya siguro si San Ireneus, the moment nang ipakita niya yung kanyang pananampalataya, ito ay kanyang nasustain. And even in the last breath of his life, pinakilala niya pa rin ang kanyang pananampalataya. Tatlong bagay ang pinapaalala sa atin kapag inaalala natin ngayon si San Ireneus and other martyrs of the church. One, sila ay tinawag. Pangalawa, binigyan sila ng misyon. At pangatlo, sila ay pinalalakas. Ano ngayon ang matututunan natin sa kanila? Una, tayong lahat ay tinawag. Tinawag tayo for whatever purpose, tinawag tayo ng Diyos. At kailanman hindi nagkakamali ang Diyos. Tinawag tayo sapagkat meron tayong mission. Kung ikaw ay may asawa, ang iyong mission, maging mabuting tatay, maging mabuting nanay, maging mabuting anak. And that is your mission. Doon natin nakikita ang ating kabanalan. Saan mang bukasyon na pinili natin, naroon ang kabanalan. Naroon ang pagiging martir natin. Naririnig natin ang pagiging tatay ay pagiging martir. Ang pagiging nanay ay pagiging martir. Mula umpisa hanggang katapusan, ang iniisip mo, walang iba kundi ang iyong pamilya. Hindi ba iyon ay pagiging martir? At even na magpapahinga ka na lang, ang iniisip mo pa rin ay yung mga mahal sa buhay. You are called. We are called. Meron tayong kanya-kanyang mission. And in the end, ano tinuturo sa atin? Hindi lamang tayo tinawag. Meron tayong kanya-kanyang mission. At ito ang dapat nating maalala. Hindi nagpapabaya ang Diyos para palakasin tayo araw-araw. Naniniwala ba kayo doon na ang Diyos binibigyan tayo ng lakas para magampanan natin ang ating mission? Ang Diyos nagbibigay ng lakas para magampanan natin yung pagtawag na ginawa sa atin ng Diyos. Today, we remember Saint Ireneus, Bishop and Martyr of the Church. At pinapaalala sa atin ng simbahan, tandaan mo, katulad ni Ireneus, ikaw rin ay tinawag. May misyon ka. At higit sa lahat, sa paggagawa mo ng misyong ito, alalahanin mo, pinalalakas ka ng Diyos. Ngayong araw na ito, dudulog tayo sa Diyos. Sa misang ito, hilingin natin upang araw-araw maalala natin, tinawag tayo, binigyan ng misyon, at tayo ay palalakasin.
Please stand.
Like the leper in the gospel, we cried out for healing. We now approach our Heavenly Father with confidence that our prayers will be answered. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may never fail in its duty of welcoming the marginalized and those excluded from society, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord may guide those involved in medical research in finding remedies for incurable diseases. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our community may reach out with love and care to people ignored by society. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick, the deprived, and the lonely may find support from their Christian brethren. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died in Christ may be received in the Lord's kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God our Father, your gifts of healing and peace encourage us in our prayers. Grant what we seek in faith through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brethren, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, our Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the sacrifice we offer you with joy on the heavenly birthday of Saint Irenaeus bring you glory, O Lord, and instill in us a love of the truth, so that we may keep the church faith inviolate and her unity secure through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy, you give ardor to their faith. To their endurance, you grant firm resolve. And in the struggle, the victory is yours through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration. And we, with all the host of angels, cry out, and without end we acclaim,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
As one family, let's pray the prayer Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity. In accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who call to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Through these sacred mysteries, we pray, O Lord, give us in your compassion an increase of that faith which brought glory to the Bishop Saint Irenaeus, and he maintained it even until death. And may the same faith bring to us, who truly follow it, justification in your sight, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Come as ascended, go in peace.
Thanks be to God.